They have been kidnapped. Let's put the picture full mass. Let me give you the background to this insanity. A Florida couple, Abigail Toussaint, left, and Jean-Dickens on the right. They have been kidnapped while on a trip to Haiti. The couple, both 33 years of age, went to Haiti to visit sick family members, but were kidnapped on a bus ride from the capital city. They have been held hostage since Saturday. Family members have been doing everything in their power to get them back. Christy D. Sormez, their niece, told NBC Miami that a group ordered her aunt and uncle off a bus and have kept them captive since. The family said that when they paid more than $2,000 of the $6,000 ransom that had been demanded, kidnappers changed the deal. It's a lot of emotions. It's devastating. You feel angry. It happened. And then you feel numb at the same time because it doesn't feel real, she said. Here's a picture of her alongside the family. The Haitian kidnappers have since renegotiated the terms to $200,000 per person, an amount Christy says the family simply does not have. Christy's sister reached out to the U.S. Embassy and the Department of Homeland Security, but got little response. Here's the response. We are aware of reports of two U.S. citizens missing in Haiti. Not missing, kidnapped, held hostage. When a U.S. citizen is missing, we work closely with local authorities as they carry out their search efforts, and we share information with families however we can. We have nothing further to share at this time. Okay? However, the U.S. Department still claims these cases are a high priority. Here's a closer look at the developing story from NBC.
We traveled to Haiti in 2021 when a high-profile hostage situation made headlines after 17 missionaries were kidnapped for over 60 days. Tonight, the State Department telling NBC News when a U.S. citizen is missing, we work closely with local authorities as they carry out their search efforts, and we share information with families however we can. Family members determined to see this couple home again to reunite with their baby, turning two this week.
We're fighting. We're going to find you. And we're going to bring you home.
Yeah, let's put up the petition. We want this family to be safe. We want them to come home. Despite these signals from the State Department, Christy is continuing her mission, already getting over 5,000 signatures on the petition to bring the family home. Keep that public pressure high. Christy's touching petition is a plea to humanity and a plea for hope. They are U.S. citizens, the petition says. They are parents. They are siblings. They are my family. They are loved. And most of all, they are people who desperately need your help. Amid the media storm circulating the situation, scammers have begun to try to take advantage by creating fake GoFundMe pages, playing on the hearts of those who would like to make a contribution. Put it up. This is a post from Christy. It says clearly, hi, we don't have a GoFundMe. I don't know who started that, but hold on to your money, please. None of us came to a decision on if we even would. According to Christy, fear of crowdfunding comes from the captors who may harm the missing couple if they think the family is getting the money. So while everyone is urged to sign the petition, that is currently the help they are requesting, all right? Okay, this is something that naturally everyone should just focus, pay attention to, make sure we hold the powers that be accountable to the actual engagement, not only of diplomacy, but being effective. Call your congressperson, call your representative. Make sure there's an advocacy. Make sure there's a public pressure, a political pressure. This is how things get done in America. It's unfortunate, but it's real. If you do not keep the public pressure high, this couple may end up dead. All right, Wosny, thoughts here?
As you guys know, I'm Haitian American myself, and so this story hits quite close to home for me. Obviously, my thoughts go out to the families of these individuals who are in a dire situation. But you know what I would like the viewers to consider is going on 100 years of U.S. state policy in Haiti. U.S. is the dominant force in Haiti in collaboration with the Haitian ruling elite. These are the conditions that those policies that they've come up with in conjunction with one another. That's the State Department and, you know, other U.S. elites like the Clintons, quite frankly, who like to treat Haiti as their personal piggy bank. These are the conditions that those policies have wrought. And this is why the situation on the ground in Haiti is so dire, that people think that this is the means by which you can get some money, is holding people hostage and demanding ransom money. So when I see how this stuff sort of bears itself out all the time, like every 10 years there's a hostage crisis in Haiti, and we see that happen all the time. But again, you know, a lot of times we'll hear people talk about, oh, look at Venezuela, look at how stupid socialism and communism and blah, 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 look at how awful and dire it is. But we never say, look at Haiti when we talk about the destructions of capitalism. And I think that we absolutely should.
Well said.